Education lobby groups are taking Basic Education Minister Angie Motshekga to task over the National School's nutrition program. In an urgent application brought before the North Gauteng High Court, the minister is accused of backtracking to reinstate the feeding program. Equal Education, its law center, and Section 27 say families with children that depend on the nutrition program are now struggling. Joining us now is Tendai Mafuma, legal researcher at Section 27. A very good morning to you, and thank you so much for your time. Take us through the merit of this case and why you believe it's so important to take it to court.
Hi, good morning. Thank you so much, Nicole, for having me on your show. So this case is absolutely important, and we have set it out in our papers why we think that we should be successful in our application. But basically, the National School Nutrition Program feeds about 9 million learners daily in South Africa. And ever since the school closed as part of the lockdown, this NSNP program has been suspended. So it's about almost more than 10 weeks now. There is 9 million learners, most of whom could depend solely on that one meal that they're given in school, have not had access to this meal. So we think that this is a violation of a number of rights that are in the Constitution, and the right to basic nutrition, which is guaranteed to all children, the right to education, because we know that when they do not have a limit, they have access to this meal, they struggle with concentrating and with learning. And also, it's really an affront on their right to dignity. Not having that meal for so long really is a difficulty for the learners and for their families. And this is why we're taking the Minister of Education to court, because the minister, the department has an obligation to make sure that these rights are met and the learners receive their daily meal.
When did it become evident that the minister has indeed backtracked on this program?
So there's been a lot of engagement with the department ever since the program was suspended to try and urge them to reinstate. And towards some time, there were a couple of public commitments by the minister and also by the head of department saying that when schools open, the program would be reinstated for all learners. However, on the 1st of June, when the minister was explaining why the reopening of schools was going to be postponed by a week, then, you know, we got the indication that she was backtracking because she started talking of intentions to feed all the learners, but there was a need to wait to acclimatize to the new environment. And she also said, very importantly, that the NS, you know, like they want to get their feet on the ground and figure out what's going on before they start the reinstate new program. And our argument is that the NSNP is not a new program. It has been in place for a long time, so it shouldn't be considered a new program. Provinces have been given the money to make sure that this happens. So what they should be doing instead is coming up with plans to ensure that all learners who are eligible should be having access to their daily meal, regardless of whether their grades have been safe they get to school.
Now, child hunger across the country has been evident. In fact, it's even broader than child hunger. The issue and the topic of food has been one that has been a pressing one during the lockdown period. Now, when it comes to ensuring that this program is indeed reinstated, what sort of time frames are you working around, and exactly what impact are you hoping this will then have?
So, you know, reinstating this program is unfortunately not going to do anything to remedy the harm that the learners and the families have been experiencing for all this time. But we really think that this should be done immediately. And so we are seeking an order from the court that the provinces actually start to show us these plans for rolling out the program to all the eligible learners within 5 days of the court order. And we hope it to be in court between the 25th and the 26th of June. So ideally, this should be done. This should have been rolled out immediately as soon as schools opened. And during the lockdown, there should have been some plan to make sure that the social relief plans that were put in place actually reach the learners that need them. And like you said, there's been quite a lot of research that has been shown that, like, due to school closures, a lot of children will miss out on their meals. I think the food and agriculture organization reported that about 350 million children in the world are missing out on a daily meal. That for most of them is the only meal that they get during the day.
Tendai, planning and implementation of this program will need to be closely monitored when it does continue again, of course, ensuring that learners are not placed at risk of getting infected with COVID-19. When it comes to those measures that need to be put in place, what will be different this time around?
I think it's actually also quite important to highlight that the department, in planning towards reopening schools, came up with a number of measures. And in all of those measures, it identified the need to reinstate the NFNP program. It also has a standard operating procedure for reopening of schools, which also speaks to the measures that should be taken to ensure that even when we're rolling out this program, children are protected and they're safe and they're not, you know, exposed to potentially getting COVID. So we do think that the government has been applying their mind to this. They just now need to show us the plans they have. There are some procedures that they have put in place to ensure that children are safe.
And in the midst of all of this, what measures do you advise that learners who are in need of this program? What are the other options for them at this time, at this point in time?
Look, for most of this lockdown period, there have been some programs with the Department of Social Development. I don't have the knowledge to speak to those, but I think there are also a lot of community action networks within communities that are facilitating the displacement of food relief parcels. There are a lot of NGOs that are also distributing food parcels. And we would encourage people to just, I think on our website, we also have a poster that we're showing a couple of NGOs that are assisting with food parcels. So I think it's important, really, to try and reach out to the social development offices and make sure that you're receiving the relief that you need. And also reach out to other non-profit organizations. But it really is important for the DBE to get moving with reinstating the school nutrition program for all the eligible learners.
And very lastly, Tendai, before we let you go, we've seen the education department being challenged in court on numerous occasions with some of those cases not really bearing any fruit. What are you hoping, or perhaps what makes you so confident that you have a solid case here that can be heard and be won?
So we are absolutely confident because we really set out the constitutional rights that have been violated in this case, which are the right to basic nutrition for children, basic education, equality, dignity. And we also set out that not having access to this nutrition will actually make the learners vulnerable to other health concerns. And we have some really strong testimonies. We've collected affidavits from a lot of learners who have just set out how badly affected they've been by not having access to this meal. But what we also further do in our papers is that we set out the fact that money has been paid to provincial departments of health, and it's a conditional grant. So this money must be used for this purpose. They do have all the resources that they need for this to be implemented. So there's no real reason for not reinstating the program. So I think, you know, we really set out strongly the violation of rights, and also we set out quite strongly the obligation that is on the department to make sure that this happens, including the obligation set out in Section 195 of the Constitution, you know, the duty to the values and principles for public administration. And we think that if this is not done, it will be a real shame. It's a continuation of a violation of constitutional rights.
Thank you so much for your time. Let's leave it there. Tendai Mafuma, former legal researcher at Section 27.